Thank you, Connie. It's my great honor to be here to kick off the Fantastic Four. Before I get started, I would like to know who in the audience are not Toastmasters yet. Would you raise your hand if you are not a Toastmasters member so I have an idea who you are? Thank you. And we appreciate you coming. Today, the presentation is mostly designed for Toastmasters members, but I hope the skills and the techniques will be applicable to you in your family, in your professional life, and in general. Let me ask the gentleman in the audience this one question. How many of you, for those who are married, go home to tell your wife, "Honey, you are such an amazing wife"? If you do this, please raise your hand. You deserve a very special award. Ken? How often? Once a year? Once in 10 years?
Very often.
Very often. I have a gift prepared for Ken. So that means for the rest of the gentlemen in the audience, hopefully after today's workshop, you will have a collection of amazing and wonderful adjectives that you can use when you go home to your wife tonight. And if you are not married yet, please say this to your parents, especially your mother. I have a different question for the ladies in the audience. Actually, it's not a question. After today's presentation, I hope you will be able to encourage your husbands, and they can learn the techniques to be more considerate and more loving. So that is the purpose of today's workshop. What was that phrase that I just said when you tell your wife, "Honey, you are such an amazing wife"? Is that an evaluation?
Praise.
It's actually a praise, a compliment. So that is actually not an evaluation. So what would be an evaluation? For example, if you had agreed with your wife that she would prepare dinner every night, by 7, there would be 3 dishes of vegetables, 1 dish of meat, and 1 soup. And every day you go home, at 7, dinner is ready. And you tell your wife, "Honey, you're such an amazing wife." That will be an evaluation, because you have agreed on certain criteria, expectations, and goals. And you're comparing what happened to these criteria. Then that phrase will be an evaluation. Is that a good evaluation? No, not good enough. Evaluations have to be specific. So just by saying you're an amazing wife, your wife wouldn't know what you're referring to, right? She wouldn't know that you're actually referring to the dinner that she prepared. So before we get started, it's very important to define what an evaluation is. An evaluation is actually to compare against a set of predetermined goals. You can look this up, so it's not in your handout. And more importantly, is to find the strength and the weakness areas to improve the effectiveness, and most importantly, that it's objective rather than subjective. What do I mean by this? To judge somebody is actually a subjective comment. It's an opinion. It's not very objective. To criticize is actually to look for the fault, not looking for the positive. An assessment is actually a classification into different categories, so that is not an evaluation. So to evaluate somebody, we need to have criteria, conditions, and goals. And that is why we have judging forms. Most of us play many different roles in our lives. And within these roles, there are expectations. Please raise your hand if you have children, if you are a mother or your father. You are evaluating your children every day, aren't you? And actually, you probably are criticizing them and judging them more often than you're evaluating them. But usually you set the parameters, you set the conditions, and then you tell them what they can do and cannot do. So that is an evaluation. So you're doing this all the time as a parent. How many of you are managers where you have to evaluate your team members. Raise your hand if you are a manager with a team that you evaluate. Not too many, okay, a few. If you are in a team, how many of you get evaluated by your supervisors? Is there a performance evaluation in your company? Raise your hand if you've been evaluated yearly or quarterly by your supervisors. So evaluation is important. So all of us have been in that position. Either you're evaluating somebody or you've been evaluated. But it's very tricky because it's hard for us to learn how to evaluate somebody, especially in Asian societies. When we grew up, our parents always focused on the points we didn't get. We hardly heard compliments. It's hard for Asian and especially Chinese to say nice things to our children. So we grow up feeling embarrassed and shy about how to compliment other people. But we also don't know how to help them be better. We don't want to criticize them. We want to help them be better, but it's also difficult because we don't want to hurt their feelings. That's why being an evaluator is very important. In my experience, in Toastmasters, I've learned that evaluation is more than saying the good things, and it's also more than just saying the areas of improvement. What I've learned is that evaluation is about observing the details. Let me repeat that. It's about observing the details. In addition to observing the details, you're also listening to what is said, what is not said, and focusing on the feelings. So there's a lot that goes into evaluations. And today, hopefully I can share with you some of the techniques that I have learned in my preparation and as a Toastmaster member. This is how we learn to be better evaluators in Toastmasters. We have speakers that deliver speeches. The speakers usually are delivering speeches from manuals with objectives, very specific objectives. And that's how we can evaluate their performance. So the speaker is following a manual with objectives. And an evaluator is assigned to give feedback to the speaker, also according to the objectives. Of course, everybody benefits. The speaker benefits, and the evaluator learns how to be a better evaluator. But more importantly is that the audience is also learning from this experience. So the audience, even without having delivered a speech, is listening to the techniques and learning how to give evaluation. So the Toastmasters method and the meeting formats work really well because everybody benefits. In today's workshop, I hope to share with you some evaluation techniques, and we will watch a video from 2013, and then you will have a chance to take notes while you're watching this video of a test speaker. And then I will show you the video of the first evaluator, the champion, from 2013, and then you can compare. I will share some contest techniques, and then we have invited a live speaker for you to evaluate. You will get to work in group discussions first, and then we will call 2 to 3 groups to come up to share what you observed in today's evaluator. So for those of you who are interested in joining the contest, today will be a wonderful opportunity for you to practice. If you don't remember anything from today's workshop, there's only 3 key points you need to remember whenever you deliver an evaluation. Only 3 key points. First, you want to provide immediate feedback. Don't wait a year until you provide feedback. Maybe that's why performance evaluation at companies don't work very well, because they're giving on an annual basis. Sometimes you have forgotten what you did well or what needs to be improved. So that's why at Toastmasters, you have a speaker deliver a speech, and after intermission, they get to hear their evaluation right away. The second point is you make sure you want that speaker to come back. And how do you do that? You have to make them feel good. It's very important, and there are different techniques that we make sure that the speaker comes back. Otherwise, we've lost the speaker. And when they come back, you want to make sure that their next speech is so much better. This is how we encourage our speakers. So these are the simple notes that you need to remember when you're giving an evaluation. You want to make sure that you protect their self-esteem, that they feel good enough, but they also have the courage to make the changes and improve their techniques. So this is the purpose of why we give evaluations in Toastmasters, and it actually applies in many different areas in our lives. How to be a great evaluator? After keeping those points in mind, listen carefully, watch caringly, think critically, and speak kindly. It's a lot to do in 5 to 7 minutes. Not easy, and that's why evaluation is very hard, because you're not listening to just the words. You have to watch their gestures, you have to think about the objectives, and when it's time for you to share and speak, you have to make sure you watch your words, that you don't hurt their feelings. So, looks easier than it seems. But make sure that your heart is in there to help the speaker. That is really important. They can feel it. Put your heart into your evaluation. You want that person to be better. We talked about knowing the speech objectives. That is really important because you don't want to randomly talk about things that they're not prepared for. And we have a manual that lists the objectives of all our C1 to C10. Even though it's there, how many of you actually read the manual? I have to confess, when I delivered my C1 to C10, I hardly read the projects. But when I became an evaluator, I read every single line, every single word, and every punctuation. Because when you are an evaluator, you're comparing their performance against a set criteria. You have to know what the criteria are. So please make sure you read the manual when you are the club evaluator. This is even more important when you are evaluating advanced speeches. We don't hear them very often. The speeches are longer, they're more difficult. Please read the advanced manuals. We can divide the C1 to C10 into basic categories, which are these: content, delivery, and language. And this actually matches the International Speech Contest judging criteria. So these are the broad categories we can look at. If you do not have any idea where the speech is coming from, you can look at these basic criteria. And we learn about them in the C1 to C10 projects. To help you, I have given you a handout of the International Speech Contest criteria. You can reference this when you are listening to today's video speaker and today's live speakers. Because we have no idea what their objectives are, but we need certain criteria to compare their performance against, right? Where are we going to get the criteria? Our standard is actually the International Speech Contest. So this is the basic format. You can come up with your own criteria when you have more experience. So this is for you as a reference. We're not judging anybody. We're not picking winners today. So this is only for your reference when you need to look at the categories. Next, how to take notes when the speaker is speaking. You have another sheet that looks like this. So this is how I take notes when the speaker is speaking. I have already divided the line for you. So this is my tip, the ultimate tip. This is what you paid for today. I try to write down as much as I can what the speaker said. So every single word, as much as I can, write down as quickly as I can, I write down everything they said. Because you want to be able to repeat that and demonstrate it. While you are writing down and listening, please make sure you're watching the speakers too. Make sure you're thinking and make sure you're feeling. There's a lot going on, so I have to write down my analysis. What happened there in that sentence, in that phrase? This is my shorthand. These are the areas that I would like to focus on. There's so many. Can't write fast enough. I have my little symbols. If I put a G, that means in this phrase, there was a gesture. I will remember there was a gesture. The voice was louder, softer, faster, and slower. I put a V for voice. Props, they show something. If I didn't understand it, I put question marks. And humor, when the audience laughed, I give them a star. There are 4 different levels of laughs. 1 star is a giggle. 2 star is a laugh. 3 star is clapping, and 4 star is everything plus crying. So if you have 4 stars in your humor, that is 4 stars plus plus plus. Then I know that was really funny. So funny is not just funny. There are different ways of being funny. And of course, whether the speaker moved and whether the stories were personal or not. So while I'm writing out everything that they said, I have all these symbols next to it. So in my 5 minutes that I'm trying to put my notes together, I would know exactly what was used. And I can refer to the sentence they said, whether it was good or not. You can see it right away. You will get to practice today. In fact, you will get to practice twice. Once from the video, and the second time with our real speaker. You may use this at your leisure to take notes and to learn this technique.
How many of you have had the experience of being so excited about school that you got up at 3 a.m. in the morning on your first day of school? That happened to me when I arrived in Canada from Taiwan many years ago to attend high school when I was 15 years old. I had already recovered from jet lag, and I was very excited. Why? It was my first day at school! Yeah. And I did not want to stay in bed any longer. So I spent 3 hours before eating breakfast writing letters to my parents and my girlfriend, who were still in Taiwan, sharing them my fascination of living in Canada and my excitement for starting school. It was one of the most exciting days of my life. I was looking forward towards meeting new classmates at a new school in a new country. I was living in a homestay family. It is a typical middle-class Canadian family. My homestay parents had to go to work very early in the morning. So I had to walk to school by myself. Armed with a map in one hand and the campus in the other, I walked bravely to school. After a very, very long walk, I finally saw the school down the road, but up a hill. So tiring. As I approached the school, I saw some students on the sidewalk. Some of them had really strange hairstyle and colors. A few were even smoking, but it didn't smell like cigarettes. Oh my God, marijuana. I'm so nervous. Then suddenly, a voice from behind me shouted, "Yo, Chinaman!" I thought to myself, I'm Taiwanese, not Chinese. So I'm just gonna keep walking faster to school. The same voice repeated, "Yo, Chinaman, you deaf?" I stopped and I turned around. I saw a group of masculine guys. They were looking at me in a very unfriendly manner. "You know Kung Fu?" Another one repeated, "Yeah, Kung Fu, Chinaman!" I walked up to them slowly, and then I looked them in the eye. I do the Kung Fu pose! "Shit! Chairman of Kung Fu!" I took a deep breath. I had thought I wasn't going to make it safely to school. After a period of time, I had a few encounters with these muscular guys. Whenever they saw me, they thought I knew Kung Fu. So When they see me, they will start running away. Later, when I was thinking about my first day of school, I then realized how important it was to be able to deal with unexpected situations and impromptu. My actions on that day led them to believe that I'm in Kung Fu. So for the next 3 years of high school, they did not dare to harm me. Reflecting this training in Toastmasters, we have table topics. It forces us to answer unexpected questions given by the table topic master. These questions allow us to gain experience in dealing with unexpected situations. In real life, just like in my first day of school, situations don't always occur according to our expectations. And when they don't, how you deal with this may affect how they interact with you in the future. Contest Master.
How many of you wrote down V for voice? When he changed his voice. How many of you wrote down G for gestures when he did a kung fu move? And how many had stars when you laughed? How many stars was that? 3 stars? Because there was no crying, right? 2 to 3. 3 means you have to clap when you're laughing. So that was my definition. So when you actually mark down everything that he delivered in his speech, oh, not this one, we watch a different one, then you have some basis for your evaluation. You had good vocal variety, good gestures, good content, and good messaging. Everything was good. That good is not good enough anymore. If you tell your wife you're so good, she's gonna wonder, really? Or is just being nice? So good is not good enough. There are lots of different ways and different adjectives we can use, from good to great to exceptional. We want our speakers to not only be good, but we want them to be great. And even better, we want them to be exceptional. How do you do this? How do I do this? I use lots of positive adjectives. This is what we usually don't see enough in evaluations. If you want to give them some suggestions, then it's important that you tell them how good their great points were, how fantastic the technique was, how dramatic, how impressive. So you have a sheet of suggested adjectives with you that is a lot more than what I have here. Instead of good, instead of great, there are many other adjectives that you can use. Now, I would like to ask you to please pick one adjective to say to the person to your right, you are fantastic. Pick a different adjective, say this to the person to your left, and tell them you are magnificent. Alright? So please pick adjectives up here or adjectives in your hand now. Please say this to the person to your left and to your right. You mean it. Please add more impact and say it louder. You are brilliant. Oh, your speech was marvelous. How did you feel when people told you that you were brilliant? Did you feel good? Yes. Yes? Connie felt awesome. This is the impact, the effect, when you use really positive adjectives. instead of good. Please change it for another word. For all the gentlemen in the audience, you may be excused. This is all you need to learn from today's lesson. Please use all of these wonderful and pretty adjectives, and especially when you talk to your wife. This is the sympathetic element in the evaluation contest. How do you be sympathetic? How do you encourage the speaker? Is to actually tell them what wonderful things they did, but we want to use positive adjectives so they really see the impact. And of course, we want to pad it with recommendations and suggestions. This is the sandwich method. Toastmasters all know this, right? We use this as the opening body, but kiss, kick, kiss method, the KKK method. Kicking is a little bit too violent. So my formula is kiss, show, kiss. You have to show them what they can do. So this is, but the showing part is really the difficult part, right? So this is the sandwich method. So that's why in the kissing part, you want to make sure that you put in really positive adjectives. So pick your adjective when you're describing a speech. And then we'll work on the showing part. Jump gave a fantastic speech. Pretty good, right? But not specific. Why was it great? And how do you know it was great? I want to know more. Jack delivered a wonderful, inspirational speech that has a meaningful message that is very relevant, delivered with heartfelt language, and enhanced with his confident voice. So you actually want to say exactly what he did, and then I will go on in my evaluation to talk about meaningful message, heartfelt language, and confident voice. And whatever he did not say will be areas for improvement. So I will start my evaluation with the three elements already. I don't know what to say. That's what evaluators always say. I have more questions for you then. Why were you confused? Was it the language? Was it the voice? Was it the organization? Was it the scope? Why were you confused? You have to think really hard. Was it the story elements not clear? But what did you like about the speech, even though you did not understand it? What other things can the speaker try? And please look at the manual questions if you are evaluating from the manual. That's very important. But even if you did not understand the speech, you have to think harder to pick up the good points, and there will be more areas for you to evaluate for improvement areas. So now I know what to say, but I don't know how to say it. I don't know enough English. Don't worry, there are lots of phrases from the CC manual that you can borrow. Well-organized speeches have several benefits for the audience. They're easy to understand, easy to remember, more credible, and more enjoyable. You can memorize this, use it in your evaluation, you will win the speech contest, the evaluation contest. This comes out right from the CC manual. There are all the phrases that you need. You don't have to invent these phrases. Not only does body language communicate confidence and power, it enhances your credibility, illustrates, and emphasizes your points. It's from the CC manual. I'm serious, right? So you have to memorize it. It's pretty long, but you can say, you can use these words. Communicates confidence, enhances your credibility, illustrates, emphasizes your points. You can take them apart too. So you don't have to invent your own sentences. So that was for the club evaluations. But we're moving on to contests. To win a contest, you need to know a lot more than the other contestants. That's how you win, right? So just being good at club evaluation is not good enough anymore. So a club evaluation and a contest, they're actually very different. In a club contest, in a club evaluation, we actually want to help the speaker to be better. Or in a contest, you actually want to win. In addition to being helpful, but you actually want to win. In the club setting, you actually know the speaker, you know the manual, you know the objectives. In a contest, you don't know anything. And in preparation for the club setting, you actually have the intermission and all the time before when it's your turn to speak. But for a contest, you have exactly 5 minutes. And of course, the judges are looking at a judging criteria, which I've also provided for you. As an evaluator, you also have a set of criteria that the judges are looking at. This only applies in a contest setting. And of course, my ratio is a little bit different. If you deliver this sandwich in a speech contest, you don't have a big chance of winning. Imagine if you have a sandwich like this for your evaluation at a contest, then you have more chances of winning, right? So we're trying to make our sandwich a lot more delicious with a lot more feelings. So this is the evaluation contest criteria for a judge. That's what they were looking at. So your evaluation has to have an analysis, recommendation, technique, and most importantly, summation. Lots of evaluators run out of time. They don't have time to conclude, so they lose 15 points right away. Make sure you leave enough time to conclude. That's why I have this chart. The green, the yellow, and the red at 2 minutes, 2.5, and 3. This is my format. I'm going to kiss them 2 times and then show them 3 times. This is my sandwich. In order to make sure I have enough time, my recommendation needs to come in before the green flag is up. Most evaluators start after the green flag is up. You only have less than a minute. That's why you run out of time for your conclusions. So I want to make sure that I only bring up very few good points, but I show it with very strong adjectives. And then I actually have my analysis here in my recommendation. So even before the green is up, I'm starting my recommendation. That's how I have enough time. That's where I get my 40% of the analysis. We're going to watch the first place winner. I hope this video works, but if not, I'll go back to the other one. But if you go to the District 67 website, you can find all of these videos. And I've coached Alex many times. You will find that he used the strategies that I shared today. And in addition to his talent and his handsome looks, he was the champion of the 2013 evaluation contest. You will find lots of similarities. But I'm not so sure whether this... I can't show this because we watched the 2015 video. So I will show you the 2015 video of the first place evaluation contest winner.
Imaginary Sean out there in the audience somewhere. Allow me, if I may, to join you as you toast yourself. Toast yourself, why? Because today you hit the big stage. Today you delivered a speech deftly using great tools of public speaking. So, in my general analysis, I would like to share with you what my eyes saw, my ears heard, and my heart felt. I saw great use of body motion. As Sean described, going into the first day of school and then seeing the people with the weird haircuts, and then the masculine, muscular guys and the swagger with which they walked, and then, finally, the kung fu, how he put up a smokescreen and dealt with the situation. My ears heard great vocal variety. As you got to part, my first day at school, it conveyed the excitement, it conveyed the tension of the moment, and then, sniffing something in the air, oh my God, marijuana! Showing the disbelief. And then, finally, when those muscular guys said, hey, Chinaman, come here! That conveyed the racial prejudice and the hatred there. And finally, my heart felt a touch of nostalgia as I went back in time when I was in school, feeling the same situation, actually dealing with the same situation with the same kung fu. And it served me well until I graduated from high school. But with the toast to yourself, I'd like to put it down for now, breathe a sigh of relief, and then say, as we heard in the TED Talk tonight, I'm not done yet. This is Sean's first day in school with this Chinaman. I call my suggestions for improvement an open and closed case. I'd like to concentrate on the opening when Sean came out onto the stage, nervous, and before he even stopped walking, he started into his speech. For speakers, especially on the big stage, get up there, take a moment, look at the audience, and then start speaking. Number two, I was writing all the great things, the body motion, the body language, all this, and I was writing so fast, and all of a sudden, contest master. I felt like I was going right off the stage. It was stopped so abruptly. And he only used 5 minutes and 40 seconds, so there was a lot of room to add in other things. In a conclusion, I would have gone back to the beginning, starting with my first day in school abroad, and then facing the unexpected situations, and then bringing the core values that he taught about dealing with unexpected situations. So, if Sean were here, that was your day in school with me. I suggest keep your eyes on the open and close, and then you will master your speech and master your life. Contest chair.
He cut it really short, right? Because his recommendations came after the green sign. And the red flag was already up. He had 30 seconds, so he cut it really short. So that's why I always recommend start your recommendation before the green flag. In the evaluation contest, you have 5 minutes to prepare, which is exactly 300 seconds. What are we going to do within that 5 minutes? This is what I do. I look at my notes with all the symbols, so I know exactly what the good points are and what was missing. I combine it with my adjectives. I pick out what I want to use. And I pick out my phrases from the CC manual. And I try to memorize it as much as I can. And, of course, I put it together in a format that actually makes sense for my evaluation. So I have to organize it somehow. And the evaluation also needs an opening, a body, and a conclusion. For me, I will always try to pick out two very strong points. And then I will try to pick three different ways I can show them to be better. And not to forget my conclusion.